Amen.
Amen.
Not bad for a first service, no practice, no nothing. Just got everybody set up this morning. Devil tried to step in the way, but no, it didn't happen. Amen. It did not happen. The devil stepping in the way. He is not going to win. He's going to try everything he can to get into the service, to get us distracted, but nothing is going to steal our joy.
Amen.
Nothing's going to steal my joy.
Amen.
Come on, Kevin. Why? I got on the full armor of God.
Amen.
And that is my joy.
That's amen. Come on,
that is my peace. Joy and peace of the Lord Jesus Christ. Nothing. I don't care with everything been going on. Everything been happening. It's happening for a reason.
Hey, come on.
I'm looking for the positive in everything. God is always positive. God is always on time. And he will put us where we need it.
Hey, come on, Teddy.
Some of them had been calling me Jonah. Jonah. That just kind of fit me perfect. And as I look back and I reflect back on it, I was Jonah. I was Jonah. I didn't do what God called me to do.
Bless you, Lord.
I didn't do what God called me to do. And now, like the song said, when he was spit out of the belly of the whale, you should have heard him yell.
Amen.
Well, I'm here to tell you something. I'm fixing to yell.
Come on, man.
I'm fixing to do what I'm called. Not just today, not tomorrow, but as long as God allows me to do it.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, I want to go to 1 John. 1 John, kind of in the back there, right before Revelation and all that. Chapter 4, verse 8. Chapter 4, verse 8. I don't need a pulpit to stand behind because a lot of times I think you got something hiding back there, amen?
Amen.
I like to keep it front and center because I am here to serve God. I am here to serve y'all. I am a servant. I'll do what the Lord calls me to do. And standing behind the box, don't work for me. I like to keep it transparent. Y'all see my shoes? I got new shoes, but hey, they're not high dollar or nothing. They just old fans, just old shoes. Just like these old clothes. They're old clothes. Yeah. Everybody has this thing that you gotta keep up with the Joneses.
Come on, Teddy.
No, I don't have to keep up with the Joneses. I gotta keep up with the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah, come on.
That's right here.
Come on, Teddy.
That's right here.
Amen.
I have to keep up with Jesus Christ and do what he tells me to do, or yet I'll be right back in the belly of that whale.
Amen.
Okay, if you've got everybody got your Bibles open, amen, ready?
Amen.
And we have seen and do testify the Father. No, down to 14. I'm sorry, I said 8. I'm sorry. Down to 14. And we have seen and do testify that the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world.
Amen.
Whosoever shall confess that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, God dwelleth in him, and he in God.
Amen.
Okay. When God is in you and you are in God, what good is it being called a child of God?
Amen.
If you don't come get your gas.
Amen.
If you don't come get your fill up on Sunday.
Amen.
If you don't get your fill up at home,
amen.
If you take that Bible home or leave it at the church and leave it closed, what good is that going to do?
Okay.
What good is that going to do you?
Amen.
Because being a child of God with no works
is dead.
It's dead.
Amen.
It's dead.
Yes.
Get all feeling good and everything to be a child of God, but if you don't do the works, you ain't going nowhere.
That's right.
You're not doing what you're told to do.
Amen.
This is more or less a sermon to myself. But I was doing
the
works, but it was the wrong works.
Bless him, Lord.
I wasn't doing what he wanted me to do.
Amen.
So when I hit my knees and I said, God, I'm giving it to you now. I'm tired of being scared. I said, the Bible tells me there's no fear. Should we not be scared, for I am with you. He was with me. This old flesh.
Amen.
This old flesh had me scared.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
And I just kept kind of dodging and weeping, but you know one thing? You can't hide from God.
Amen.
You can't hide from God. He's going to put you in places that you didn't want to be. I never asked to be up here. I never wanted to be up here.
Bless him, Lord.
But God wanted me to do it.
He put you up there.
Because he got a purpose for it.
Amen.
He got a purpose. He died on that cross for
it. Amen.
He rose again in 3 days.
Amen.
Amen.
God sent his son, Jesus.
Amen.
I'm washed by the blood of the Lamb.
Amen.
So I'm there to do what he called me to do. And we have known and believed, and the love that God had gave to us. God is love, and he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God in him.
Amen.
Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world.
Amen.
Amen.
I've got love in me. Got Jesus Christ in my heart.
Bless him, Lord.
I've repented of my sins. I've been washed clean.
Bless him, Lord.
But I am in this world.
Amen.
I am in this world. I'm not of the world.
That's right.
Amen.
I'm not of the world.
Amen. Come on, Teddy.
I am in this world. So I have to strive. You have to strive to be like Christ.
Amen.
Because you tell me it is really, really hard. When someone has come against you, when people are persecuting you, they're talking about you, it is really hard to, especially for me,
Amen.
Keep my mouth shut.
Amen.
But you know what? God bless them. God bless them. May they get into a church where they don't try the drama of bringing other people down, to bring other people churches, because they're only doing what God called them to do.
That's right.
Preach
it, Teddy. It's not about feelings. It's not about friendship.
Amen. Come on.
It's about God's word.
Amen.
And
Amen.
The love of the brother.
Amen.
I have fought. God has fought several battles for me.
Bless the Lord.
I sat back with a smile on my face. I sat back at peace.
Bless
they
Lord.
Can't touch me.
Right.
They could, the world can say I'm this. The world can say I'm that.
Come on, Teddy.
But I know my heart.
Amen.
I know what God has for me. I know
Amen.
What God plans for me.
Amen.
And I will not strike another brother in Christ down.
Amen.
Come on, man.
Come on,
brother.
I will not bring reproach on another church.
That's right.
Come on, Teddy.
The Bible says we're not supposed to.
Amen.
Preach it, Teddy.
So that's how you get your peace.
Amen.
Amen.
You don't just run out, slap the far out of Nellie Bell somewhere because she got her own mouth running. You don't go out and just persecute people that persecute you.
Amen.
Persecute me all you want to. I'm going to love you.
Amen.
And I'm going to pray for you.
Amen.
Come on, Teddy.
Billy, my Lord.
There is no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out fear.
Amen.
Amen.
Perfect love casteth out fear. Well, guess where my fear went? Gone. It's gone. Yes. I am not going to fear anything that the Lord calls me to do.
Amen.
If it's to pray with somebody like I do at the fuel pumps, if it's to tell them, hey, you don't got to come to my church. You don't got to come to the building that I have here because you are the church.
Amen.
Amen.
Go where the Holy Spirit leads you to go.
Amen.
You just invite people.
That's right.
And God will send them.
Amen. Amen.
God will send the ones that you need.
That's right.
Amen.
The ones that I'm supposed to shepherd. The ones that I'm supposed to feed. The ones that are supposed to be here.
Amen.
Is here.
Yep.
Amen.
Amen.
As soon as I figured that out, told me you need to get your little self out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing to be afraid of.
That's right.
For I am with you, and I will send you the ones that's supposed to come.
Hallelujah.
Just like when I get up here, I open my mouth, he's going to fit it. I don't know what's going to come out of it.
Amen.
Half the time I never do anyway.
That's
And I don't care what comes out of it, because I know it's going to be something godly.
Amen.
I know it's going to be something godly. I know who's going to fill my mouth. I know who these sermons and these sayings and these teachings are supposed to be for, because they'll be sitting right here when they're supposed to on God's time.
Amen.
Not because I called everybody up wanting them to come and visit me. I ain't called the first person.
Amen.
I ain't talk bad about the first person.
Bless him, Lord.
I'm not going to. I just say, God, wrap me in your arms. Take me where I need to go.
Amen.
And send the ones that you're going to see.
That's right.
Amen.
And they're coming.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
They're coming. They might have to come back around, but they'll come. Because God, the truth, the life, and the way.
Jesus. Amen.
Number one being the truth. The truth is the first thing. The truth will stand when the world is gone.
Amen.
There'll not be a rock, there'll not be a boulder, there'll not be nothing when the world is gone, but the truth is going to be there.
Amen.
The life. Oh, what a life.
Amen.
Oh, what an abundance of joy I get in my heart. When it's time for me to get my Bible up, when a certain little sign on the side of the road tell me, feed my sheep.
Amen.
In a place I don't even know. And that thought hits me. Okay, God, I get your sign. It could be a little word. It could be seeing something on the back of a truck that'll strike me. Like John 3:16 or something. Just a special word. Everybody knows John 3:16 by the heart.
Yes.
Amen.
But it's all in the way you read it. Mm-hmm. God will reveal to you what you're supposed to do.
Amen.
Amen.
He'll let it all come out on Sunday morning.
Yes.
Standing in front of you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So the love. The love of Jesus Christ is the way. You've got the truth, the life, and the way.
Amen.
And that way is put out in front. You go that way.
Amen.
Because that's the only way you're going to get in there.
That's right.
That's the way that we get this, out of this world of sin. None of us is without sin.
Amen.
None of us is perfect.
That's right.
Amen.
None of us is more high and mighty than the other.
Amen.
Amen.
We're just children of God.
That's right.
That want to go to heaven.
Amen.
That want to go to heaven.
Yes.
Amen. We have to overlook some people in our lives, some things that go on. If you keep your focus on God,
come on,
it may not seem like it's going to work right then. And you might make a little bad decision and get there just a little bit like I did to get out. But he's going to put you right back where you want it as long as you stay focused on him.
Amen.
As long as you obey his word, his commandments, keep him first, he's going to put you where you want to be.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
And yes, this old body, this old mind, it bothers me when I hurt another human being. But when I'm standing on the Word of God, I'm going to do what He says to me.
Amen.
No matter how bad it hurts this body. Because I am here to please Him.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm not here to please anybody or anything. No. I want to please God. I want to be a God pleaser, not a people pleaser.
Amen.
I want to be God. Because I'm trying and striving to be like Christ. That people get these worldly opinions in their mind. They're not looking at it as my love for God.
Mm-hmm.
My love for the Savior. They're not looking at it as, hey, he's just doing what the Bible told him to do, what God told him to do, he's standing on it. They go, oh yeah, he just this, he just that. Well, send it to me.
Amen.
Send it to me.
Amen.
You know, I'm rubber and you glue. It's going to stick right back on you. Amen. It's going to come back and stick right back on you.
Amen.
God will supply my needs. People don't.
That's right.
People do not supply my needs. God supplies my needs.